10 million people, you know, join this thing. And then, do you know the amount, at least the contribution we're going to be making in my area? Look, primary education, primary healthcare is totally in the state of disrepair, right? It is, there's nothing functioning. So things like that around, you know, Western region where, you know, one can, you know, use that platform to support them financially.
Hold up, you remember, right? On this platform, right? When we put together like almost 6 to 7 million, I can't remember the exact figure, right? That time, right? And then we decided to procure educational materials for school children. Over 15,000 school children in Yorubaland benefited, right? And not just that.
Yeah.
We took more than 20, I'm sorry, we paid more than 20 children's school fees around the time. And we adopted 4 of them that we put in schools right now. Well, the reason why we decided to go and do it in a proper way, where everybody can actually contribute and be part of it. You see, money is the least of the advantage of the union when it's finally formed. It is the discovery of committed Yoruba professionals, doctors, lawyers, doctors, nurses, generally like that, teachers and all that, right? People who are going to volunteer because of their profession, we're going to discover them through the union. So imagine if we say, okay, we have a union, Yoruba union of a million member fold. Out of that 1 million, they have Yoruba Union has more than 15,000 identified registered professional doctors. Yoruba Union has about 1,000, pediatricians. Or Yoruba Union has in their fold, they have 50,000 school teachers. Okay. Or we have this order, so we can pull from that. We can pull from that resources. Okay. To pursue what we are going to do in Yoruba land. We want to make Yoruba Union to become the main thing that Yorubas talk about. And it's not talking about Yoruba Union just based on Yoruba nation independence. No, it has to be something that they will say when it comes to their education, there is an impact of the union. When it comes to their safety, security, right? Yoruba Union is involved. When it comes into their commerce, economy, there is a Yoruba Union Bank in Yoruba land that is giving interest free, you know, that kind of thing that actually affect their everyday life. Once we become and the people ask for Yoruba nation, and nobody will stop them when they are ready.
It is possible.
Do you get that now?
It is definitely possible. Good. Because, but it is down to numbers. When this, you know, is, you know, get on rolling, to be honest, sky will be. In fact, will be the limit.
Can you imagine the possibilities if this comes to light eventually? The possibility of what you can actually really do. Now, the union has a membership deal. When you join the union, we haven't agreed on what, okay? I was proposing $1 or £1, but some said that, you can do more than that, right? So I said that, let's say $1 or £1, and the union has, for example, 100,000 members. Now, that's £100,000 sterling. Every month that could go into a lot of things in Yoruba land, promote a lot of things, sponsor some people on so many things that actually have to benefit Yoruba land.
Infrastructure in that area is the key. Your schools, hospital, vocational centers. Right,
those are very important things. Hire doctors, hire nurses. The union will pay them, but they should go and work in government offices. I mean, government hospitals. They should go to government schools and teach the children. But we will pay them, not the government. You get what I mean?
So it has to be so like a real organization.
You get what I mean? Once they have this, you know, life-threatening medical stuff, right? And they had to come on social media to raise money. We want to kind of see if we can stop that. Rather than go on social media and beg for money, 2 million naira, 3 million naira for your medical stuff, just go and talk to the union. Union should be able to take care of that for you.
Yes, so that's and what the idea.
Yeah, that's what we want to do. Not just those in Nigeria. Yeah. I'm talking about us here too. If I have any problem in the UK, I want the union to stand up for me. Get me a lawyer. Do you get that? So if I have a problem, housing problem, right? I want to approach the union. If our union has a 1 million membership per food, and I have a housing problem in the UK, in America, in Canada, I can speak to the union there. I need help.
Yeah.
The union could come to your aid. Stuff like that are the ideas and objectives of the union. Just people should know. Yoruba Nation is the goal. But there is more and before we get to that. There is so much more to be done before we get to that.
Yeah.
You get an order.
Yeah. So, and then I saw something in, I don't know, in Bangladesh or something, that where there are a lot of people in the town center where there's so much, lot of people there. So I am kind of wondering, why is it that that momentum hasn't got to that point in Nigeria as we speak? So I just hope that it will get to that point, because
it is the government that will provoke the people to make it get to that stage. They're going to do something. Right now, everybody is hearing. They've killed 43 people. Some people are not even moved. Now, there is going to be something that's going to happen within these days that will eventually get everybody to say, you know what, Omo, we are joining. Oh, it's like, Omo, forget it. I'm joining. You know what I mean? It will get to that stage. Hold up. Watch out.
Yes. Yes. Thank you for listening. And then, you know, things will be fine.
Well, let's hope so. But we need to do something to make it fine. And we won't stop kind of trying. Okay, Baba? You have a good one yourself. Yeah. Hold up.
Thank you. Cheers, man. You too.
Cheers.
Yeah.
So that's hold up there, calling from Leeds here in the UK, right? So the next one now is my brother, another brother from another mother, Yima. Gudu, it's been a while.
Hey, my Egun.
Yima.
Ekaso, my Egun.
Fantastic.
Adupe,
Baoni family.
Praise God, Baba. Praise God.
Bless you, man.
Hey, my Egun.
Here we are.
Here we are. I'm in the observation seat. I am watching as the protest is going on.
It's unfolding.
And I'm seeing things, and things are happening. Well, I wasn't expecting anything from Kalu's speech, presidential speech. Anyway, I said it before, it's going to be cut and paste, and he's going to double down on his fake reality that he is being fed. And I just didn't expect anything from the address in the first place. So anybody who was expecting that Kalu would say anything meaningful needs to go and get a brain surgeon to re-examine their head. If you're expecting Kalu to tell you something good.
You should address us. Address you, Ken.
Address you for what is it going to address you?
What your demands, man.
So if you were there expecting Kalu to say something nice on his presidential speech, then I don't know where your madness has stopped or begun. As for Kalu, his commissioner of police came out and said that they are doing a great job. We can see the great job that you are doing, driving APC trucks at protesters in Kano who were innocently protesting. The real people that were looting, you did not go there and catch them. It's the people that were protesting innocently. You drove armored tank at them, beat them in the streets like animals, ran over them, shot some live on TV. Even your police officer.
You didn't run over. You started hitting them until you
hitting them.
Top of them. Like, what the heck?
Your police officer stood there live on camera.
They killed
saying it in Hausa.
One of their police officer too. You saw that one. I don't know if you saw
it.
They killed him.
I saw it.
They used their APC to run the police officer down. The guy died in shock.
The ID said that they're doing a great job. Kalu came out and commended them. It's normal for Nigeria. Logic is always turned upside down in Nigeria. So it's just one of those normal things that they do. Policeman, your job is to serve and to protect the citizen.
No,
you stand for open. In the video, you know they are videoing you, and you are saying in the house that Zankeshi Waye, you will keep us in house. And that's a good job? Well, that's fine with me. If they call that a good job, they're doing a very marvelous job. Your same police with the UK here had riots. Nobody died.
No.
People were arrested the next day. They had their mayhem. The next day, people were being picked up from their homes.
Nobody
the same police you be.
Hello, open the police. Yesterday,
no be police, you be
on the street. Yeah, go back to your country. Yeah, all of that. The following morning, police. Hi, police. You are in handcuffs. They've already arrested over 23 people on this ongoing.
So, what's the difference between? What is the difference between the police that is here and the police that is in Nigeria? You will come out and say, don't be comparing UK police with Nigeria police. Shut up. Your politicians and your obas are comparing UK inflation and Nigeria inflation. You did not call them, you did not tell them to stop comparing the inflation. But when it is police that they are doing the same, what is the job of police? The same thing. So why is it the one is killing people openly and the other one is arresting people and prosecuting them?
So even though the protesters, you call protesters here, they are like violent anyway.
Violent.
They are like already attacking police, beating police up. Police, they get bruises for their face because then they do protest.
So
police, they get bloodshot eye because then they do protest. You know what I mean? Yet nobody.
Michael, tell me, is that not madness? Mm. Is that not madness? Now you have protesters in Kano and Kaduna protesting with Russian flags. I'm sure Russia is a very beautiful and marvelous place, and Mr. Putin is an all right guy. He's probably laughing at Nigeria, Britain, France, and America now. He is in your next border in Niger. He has operations in Niger right now as we are speaking. Yes. There are Russian soldiers in Niger.
Yes.
Nigeria and Niger has so the most porous borders that anybody can just throw through it.
Yes.
Putin doesn't have to involve himself in all of this nonsense fight. All he has to do is
for anybody interested in Nigeria.
He's not. He Nigeria doesn't care.
Yima, people don't know that Nigeria is at our weakest. It has ever been in history. Any country can take over Nigeria now. Easily. Can take, your military. The moment they shoot, the moment they bomb your military headquarters in Abuja, all of them there, you begin to see your military ships. If they survive, they will be running away to the borders.
They will move. Nigeria
is at its weakest ever as we speak. So vulnerable and ready.
Putin doesn't need to do anything. All Putin needs to do
anything. You know?
He just needs to just arm Niger very well and tell Niger, my friend, push all the Islamic terrorists towards the Nigerian border. Shikena, they will enter. And they will cause trouble in the northern Nigeria, as if they are not doing right now. But you have the Minister of Defense. Where is he from?
Jigawa.
The north. You have DSS. Where is he from?
The same north. That one is from Kwara, I think.
You have NSA. Where is he from?
NSA is also Ribadu, from Adamawa.
And these are the northern criminals that will allow people kill their own people. But if somebody from the southeast was holding a Russian flag. My ego, you and I know the story will for nobody.
Media will say IPO started there with Russia.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much. Don't be me tokamu. You all know. Thank you, my ego, Baba. Well done, Jerry.
This stinks, Yima, my brother. You have a very good week yourself, okay? Enjoy the rest of the week, man.
Yes, man.
Nice one, okay? So that's a Yima, a Gudu, a brother from another mother. I'm going to call it a day now so that I can go get ready, like, for the evening. I've been seeing a lot of things going on there. I'm using my right eye to check on that. So I want to say a big thank you to all of us, every one of us. And there's nothing much to say though, right? I will see you later this evening when we will have a full recap of what really happened or went down in Nigeria on the fifth day of End Bad Governance, the Days of Rage. Thanks a lot for your time, and you all have a beautiful afternoon. If you are not already in the afternoon, and if you are, I'll say you have a beautiful week too. Okay. Good afternoon.
do. Shiri ya jelu ki ibo ni be o
aye ku diary da ibi no
o ba se ani maye ku ma wi
aye ku diary da ibi no
o si tun se re wa go ni be o
aye ku diary da ibi no
aye ku diary diary politico
aye ku diary da ibi no
Godfather is in Sila Romaya,
Maya Kundaya, Naipi Nupawa,
Evara Baleseo, Kegorolenu,
Maya Kundaya, Naipi Nupawa,
Ani, Maya Kulawamo, Lawamo, Toto, Toto,
Maya Kundaya.
Oje lu esun raki
aye ku ti de
ani esun raki
aye ku ti de
lori Facebook
aye ku ti de
ani esun raki
aye ku ti de
lori YouTube
aye ku ti de
ani esun raki
aye ku ti de
bo baba de wure
aye ku ma wi
ani esun raki
aye ku ti de
ijo igbadi ye Presido ba rufi o
aye ku ma mi
ani esun la
aye ku ti de
iko ni na gowo je
aye ku ma mi
ani esun la
aye ku ti de
olopa tin da riba
aye ku ma mi
ani esun la
aye ku ti de
asofi tin rufi o
aye ku ma mi
ani esun la
aye ku ti de
ogura o lo se lu Ani esun la
aye ku ti de
oje lu esun la ki
aye ku ti de
ani esun la ki
aye ku ti de
aye ku ti de gogo oje lu esun la ki Maye kunti de gogo oje lu esun la ki sugar ni ba ti se to ye ki won se omo ba de ro ni fi won ni ran o eya
maye kunti de gogo oje lu esun la ki maye kunti de gogo oje lu esun la ki Sugani bati se yi to ye ki won se omo ba de ro ni fi won ni ran
won fo wo be o maye kun o so pe wo o be be won fo wo be maye kun o so pe wo o be be oni kan sa ti se yi to ye ki won se pa won ra ilu to pe won de be o aye
Maye ku ti de gogo oje lu esun la ki Maye ku ti de gogo oje lu esun la ki Sugbe ni ba ti se yi to ye ki won se omo ba de ro o ni fi won ni ran
Ha ki ma yi se re oro yi ki ise fe ki ma yi se re Ọ̀rọ̀ yìí kì í ṣẹ̀fẹ̀ ẹni bá ti lè lẹ́bọ̀ lẹ́rù o ọmọ bá dèrò kàṣà ètú wọn síta
Maye kun ti de gbogbo ọjà lu ẹ̀sùn ra kí Maye kun ti de gbogbo ọjà lu ẹ̀sùn ra kí Sugbe ni bá ti ṣe yìí tó yẹ kí wọ́n ṣe ọmọ bá dẹ́rọ̀ o ní fi wọ́n ní ràn.
Tẹni tẹni ọmọ Mayekun ọ̀rẹ́ ará ìlú màmá ni. fọlọ́run sọ ẹ bá kìlẹ̀ lóòótọ́ olódodo ìlú ọ̀tá ìlú mọ̀mọ́ ni ìwọ ṣá máa ń ṣọ́ra kò sì mọ bẹ̀rù bọ́tà lè rí bóníṣègùn lé káwọn mọ̀mọ́ fi ṣera wọn ni ó ti dẹrùn tí wọn ò gbọ́dọ̀ sì mọ́bẹ̀.